This walk was originally created for 20 people. It was much easier to adapt it to 14, in fact, because I could provoke more characters within. So the process became, in some ways, quite easier and more accessible for me. Yeah. Look, look front, look front. No, yes, 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 yes. Okay, that's it. Make it a walk, like a very stylish walk. You just walk, you know? Yeah? One more time. The hardest part is always behaving on stage, not moving. Exactly. Good. In a way, the piece meant to portray various pictures versus various song. It's very unusual and different than what I usually do. I've been traveling to Cuba several times, having seen the passion they have toward life, how creative they are in terms of means, but mainly the joy they have with salsa. Most of the music was created by Perez Prado, the composer. During the 50s, my mom played the music all the way till the 70s at home. We had a great gramophone. While I created, I realized, wait a minute, this is something that I heard at home. It sounds familiar. That was the starting point. I start to understand that if I want to work with this music, I have to find and fish different ideas, different stories. For instance, when you walk in Cuba, it's very common that a woman just punch a man in his butt. Punching the butt in the West is like a very humiliating way of, you know, one treating each other. Over there, it's the other way around. It's full of joy, full of intention. But at the same time, it's also sending a message to the outside, don't mess with what is mine. So this moment when you see the man dragging a woman and she's like, just flipping her hands from side to side. And in a way, it's really taken from one animated pictures that I've seen. I think it was even in the New York Times, like the caveman holding a woman with the hair and dragging her. This is in Cuba usually happen when there is a fight between two men. It's like two roosters, you know, that are fighting for life. The process with the costumes had to do a lot with the type of personalities I wanted to portray. You know, there is this distinguished gentleman. He's wearing this kind of vest, under vest, white shirt, as if he's going afternoon to have a drink with his friends. There is Ben. He's the guy who just likes to party. Colorful, flashy, and into pleasure, constant pleasure. The nerd is a little bit dressed like Larry King, though he's not Larry King, he's a nerd. There is the top model, and she dressed a little bit like a ballerina, but she is top model. She's slick, she is serious, she's long, and she is having an attitude. In a way, she is snob versus other ladies who are more street-like, more sweet and voluptuous. One of the characters in the piece, his name is Mark. I had a hard time to break his character because he was reserved. So what I tried to do is to dress him a little bit like a Miami Cuban guy. White suit, red shirt under, and a chain gold. I sent him to look at some videos, and I was very surprised. He really got into it. And if you see him in real life, he's like a totally different personality. So it's a really successful case for me in relationship to this particular work. Oh, look at this. I have to have you like that. Mira, flequito.
I can do it.
So slowly we just draw up the character. Then I start looking in journals and thinking what fits the characters I choose. I send some sample to Anne-Marie, and she start looking for materials. And when I arrived here, she had plenty to show me so we can choose and create in one way very individual, but on the other hand, creating the whole frame that everything blend one with the other. Movement joined together with the costumes will provoke the persona, will bring the character out. Ideally, it would be nice to have legs, so you see only the light. Then it's
only the light, not the pole.
It would be nice. It also create even better sense of depth.
Yeah.
Then it's really beautiful. The third, second and first, lower them, so maybe to 80. The type of light in Cuba is very, very basic. Because of that, I choose also the most basic light bulbs there is in the market. Everywhere in the world, you can find those lights because it's have a certain texture, mentality. The function of the light have a very important means. It's manipulate the eye to look to where it's lit. Positive manipulation, I would call it. On top of that, it's a little bit diagonal so the audience can see where it comes from all the time. You cruise through space to always place where it leads and then something happened there. Either it's solo or duet, individual story. The good things about that, if the company travel, they can always use the cheapest lighting.
Yeah! Casual, casual. You are very exhausted. You have big step. You are full of energy. You move the house, you like to move it 10 more times. Ready? Can we do it one more time before we do it again? Yeah?
I like to use humor because it breaks the person who sits in front of me and put them in a light mood. For me, humor is just a tool of communication. When a person is in a light mood, there is a better sense of accessibility, exchange. When they loosen up, I start reading them. And when I read them, I get more out of them.
Ready? And go. It's nice, huh?
I feel that now when I will leave, it's in a good hand. It's in a good hand. The baby start running very fast. You may have hard time to catch him, and he will be full of life. My mother still haven't seen it, so hopefully soon she will.